Hi guys, welcome back to our channel. In the previous video, we guide you how to install the LearnPress plugin. So, in this video today, I will show you how to configure the LearnPress plugin and install the default theme step by step. Okay, first of all, we will learn how to configure LearnPress. Simply go to the dashboard, in the LearnPress, choose setting. Now, you can see your setting screen. In the general, you can change, edit, or create new default page such as all cross page, profile page, checkout page, become instructor page. Below, either term and condition, also logout redirect. In the currency section, you can choose the currency you want and also the currency position. And now, let's scroll down to the publish profile part. User can show or hide their course or quizzes when other user visit their profile page. To do it, first, click on this box, save setting. And then, we will check the profile. In the setting, choose privacy. Now, drag down, you can see two boxes, course and quizzes. Now, click on both of them and save change. And in the instructor registration part, user can request to become an instructor in a registration or not. You have to click on enable this option and click save setting to make it possible. Now we will go through the login page. Here, as you can see, the box want to become an instructor is here. To make sure all user can register, in the dashboard, you will choose the setting and click on the general section. Navigate to membership and click on the box anyone can register, otherwise no one gonna be able to register. In the end, click save change. Next, we'll go to see the course tab. Here, we can enable review course. With this feature, after the instructor creates a course, the course will be in a pending state, and only the administrator can publish it. If you disable this feature, there will be no review course function. And with auto start, after student purchase the course, the system will automatically enroll the course for you with the continue button. If you disable this feature, student have to click on the sign up button to enroll in the course. And to show a confirmation pop-up before finishing a course or completing an item, you can tick enable pop-up confirm finish course complete item. You can choose either list or grid type to display with archive page layout. And you can change the number of course displayed per page in the course per page feature here. Then we drag down and click save setting. That's all for the course tab. Now let's move to the profile tab. This section will allow you to change avatar dimension, the feature enable login form and enable register form will display the login form and the registration form on the profile page if the user doesn't log in. Also, you can enable default fields like first name, last name, display name, or even custom register field. Remember to tick on the require to make it a required field. Also, you can edit permalink as well. After all of that, click save setting. So next is a payment tab. In the general, you can enable guest checkout, enable login form in checkout, and enable register form in checkout. Also, you can custom order slot. Then move to the PayPal. You can enable PayPal standard and then enter your PayPal email here. The sandbox is just for testing. You can disable this after publishing your site. Now click save setting. And now we will move on to the email tab where you can configure email. In the general tab, you can edit from name content type, header image, footer text, and enable, disable the event which you want to use. Remember to click Save Change afterwards. And if you want to edit email content, click on the Manage in the user here. In this tab, you can write any content here and then click on Save Setting. And the last one is the Advanced tab, where you can manage styles, enable Gutenberg about course, lesson, quiz, and question. Also, we provide debug mode, where you can enable debug mode for developer. Also, you can change the position of question navigation. And now, click Save Change. Well, that's all for how to configure the LearnPress plugin. Now, we'll guide you on how to install the default tips. First, open the WordPress admin dashboard. In the appearance, choose Theme. You can choose Add New or Activate the theme that you want to use. You should use the 2020 or 2021 theme to test the LearnPress plugin. Currently, we provide some premium themes integrate with the LearnPress plugin to help you have a professional e-learning website in the easiest way, such as Eduma, Coaching, Coachain, or even so. Hopefully, you understand our guide today, and thank you for watching. See you guys again in the next tutorial. Goodbye!